Hello, Walking Dead fans. This is Solid Dave Snake bringing you a very special action figure review today. And as you can see in front of you, this review is going to be on the just announced and just released Skybound exclusive Jesus action figure from the Walking Dead comic books. And I was amazed that they released this info just last Friday, put it up for sale this Monday, and it was already at my doorstep today. I just think that's incredible that McFarlane was able to keep this such a great secret, and they kind of did this with the Negan and Ezekiel as well. Seems like they're really keeping these Skybound exclusives under wraps for a while, and it's really nice, because as soon as you hear about it, boom, it's right there the next week or week after. And you can actually get these figures on the Skybound site. I know they have it on hold right now while the Comic-Con's going on, because you can get it there, but these will probably be right back up, because Negan's were still selling for, after a year, whenever they released. But yeah, I was really excited to get this action figure. Jesus is one of my favorite characters from the comic books now. He's really badass. Whenever he's first introduced in the comics, he kind of brings Rick into the whole community, all the other communities that they're working with now in the comic books, and kind of brings in that Negan story arc as well. And the character himself really doesn't even use that many weapons in the comic books. They've never released it about his background yet, but from what I've seen, he seems to have some kind of background in mixed martial arts or something to that effect. I myself used to do mixed martial arts, and it was just very noticeable in the comic books by the way he fights. But maybe they'll release that in the future, but that's one thing I always thought was neat about him. And they articulated this character. They gave him the updated leg articulation, so you can get him to throw kicks and everything, but I have a lot of complaints that I'll get into later when I go over the articulation. But the sculpt and paint and overall presentation of this character is actually incredible. They did a really good job on this. They have for their past couple Skybound exclusives. So I'm really happy that they're continuing these. And I will quit yapping and get into this figure now. And right off the bat, we will go over his accessories first. And the only complaint I really have with his accessories, and I really don't even care that much because I have so many of these M4s. They've been releasing these with a lot of these Walking Dead characters. But mine is warped. If you can see, that barrel is bent downwards. Right here at the foregrip. So that's kind of a letdown if you didn't have this accessory yet and it showed up like this. But for me, it's not that big of a deal. I've got plenty of these and probably won't even really display them with this too much. But it is the exact same one that came with Merle and a lot of the other characters. It's got that same double sling on it, which I would have actually preferred the single sling. I like that look better. It's just a little too much. But that's one accessory. And his other is this pair of binoculars from whenever you first are introduced to him in the comic book, and he's scoping out the Alexandria safe zone before he goes in. He's looking over the community with these binoculars. And it's got that nice blue effect right there on the lens. Give it that glass look. None on the other end, that would have been nice. But this is made out of a real soft plastic too, which I actually like that kind of plastic better. As you can see, I can just bend the crap out of it. So that's one neat new accessory. And it says on the back of the packaging that he's supposed to come with a knife, but he does not. It's not in the package, so not really a big letdown to me, but kind of would have been nice. And when he is first introduced in the comic books, he does have a sheath with a knife on this side of his hip. But his other accessories are this bandana around his neck, which I will take off here in a minute to show you the other head, but I want to show you this head first, probably the one I'll be presenting him as. And it is a great representation of Jesus. He looks just like how we all kind of perceive Jesus Christ to look. He has the same exact features. And they did a great job in the sculpt with that. Really defined in the face. An excellent job with the hair and the beard. His hair is actually really pliable. As you can see, I can pull it back. And it continues on to the back. Looks really good. And to show you that bandana accessory, I gotta pop off this head and then I'll pop on his other head. But be really careful with these if you get it, because it feels a little tight whenever you're pulling it out, and it's very hard to get back in. But just pull that out. It's tight, like I said. And when you finally get it off there, that bandana, you can take off. I'll give you a closer look at it. And it's real soft plastic, too. Got a little knot tied in the back. So that was really nice they didn't sculpt that on there and gave that to us for a second head. And here at the base of the head, you can see that ball peg in there. He's got one connected in his head and the other that goes into the neck. And it's more complicated to get these on than take them off. But we'll pop this one on now. And you kind of got to hear for it to pop in and know that it's going to stay there. And this is his alternate head. This is how he first looked when he did first appear in the comic book before he introduced himself to Michonne and Abraham. When he was looking through those binoculars at the Alexandria safe zone, he had that bandana around his face like that. And the toboggan on his head, which is nice to get a totally different look out of this head sculpt. I like that a lot. And that toboggan is detailed really nice. So, great head sculpts on this figure. And now we'll take a look at the rest of his body. And he does have this long green coat on when he first appeared, and it has a lot of stitching detail in it and wrinkles and just overall texture. When you run your finger down it, it's kind of lumpy. Of course, that goes on his sleeves, and he's got black gloves on his hands. And under that coat, he has what looks like to be a couple other shirts or jackets, that bottom one being blue. And then he has bandolier around his body with bullets in it, and more ammo down here around his belt. And I'll pull this coat back a little bit, let you see his pants. They're just regular brown bottoms. He's got some straps going around his thighs, and then he's got these black style of army boots. And there's actually tread on the bottom. So really great detail all around, even to be on the bottom of his feet. It's absolutely great. So this Jesus looks unbelievable, but I'm a little let down in his articulation. And the only reason being that a lot of it kind of limits the posing abilities of some of the crazy attacks that he does in the comics. For one, at the head, it is kind of limited because of the hair. Even though it's soft, just the way it is, you can't really get that much up and down movement out of it. Although you can spin it from side to side, but especially with this head, the bandana catches it right there along the coat. So you can't really get it too far to the side. Just about right there, and then right there. And at the shoulders, he does have that ball joint and hinge. Let me get a focus in here again. Okay. He's got that ball joint and hinge, but you can only get his arm raised up about that much by the way the top of this shoulder is. So that limits a lot, although you can rotate it all the way around. And he has the ball hinge, ball joint and hinge here at the elbow, which will go that far up and then back straight. And you can rotate it. And at the wrist, it's kind of weird. You can spin it, and it's on a ball joint and a hinge, but you really can't get that much movement out of it. Only about, that's it, about one click, because the way the coat is kind of hinders that hand. So that kind of limits a lot he can do there too. But probably one of the biggest disappointments with the articulation is he has no waist swivel, which really restricts a lot as well. In this figure, we really could have used an ab crunch as well. A waist swivel in an ab crunch is kind of what we needed to get some of these poses out of him. But below that, he does have that updated leg articulation that Daryl had and all the rest of the figures in that comic book series 3 had, which has the cut to raise his leg up. But that's not a kick. I mean, that's not one of the kicks that Jesus throws. You can't get it that far up because of these bullets, these belts with the bullets around his waist. And he does have that kicking out to the side motion too, which it was kind of needed for him to throw some of those crazy kicks. But overall, it just kind of looks weird. And really, his legs almost look a little too short. A little bit longer would have been nice for the way his character attacks with his legs all the time. But he does have single-jointed knees. Let me get it out of the way of the trench coat, and it will only bend about that far down. So that's not too good either. So he's got that ball joint and hinge there. And he has no foot articulation. All he has is this cut right here at the boot, which will swivel around. So overall, articulation-wise, to me, he feels kind of weak. I really don't feel I'll be able to pose him in some of the ways I would want to. But all in all, I'm just really happy that we got this figure at all. And I also want you guys to check out a couple other reviews that some fellow YouTubers are going to be doing on him as well. Good friend from Make a Path Presents, he is going to be doing a collector's review on this with going over the packaging and all that stuff. So if you want a good look at the packaging, go ahead and check out his review. And Mr. Evil Cheese, one of my favorite Walking Dead YouTube reviewer. He'll be reviewing this as well. And if you're a fan of Mr. Evil Cheese, you know he's hilarious, and I'm sure has something great planned for his video. So check those out. I'll have the link in the description below for those videos whenever they get done. And also, check out a Facebook page that I am an administrator over at. It is called The Walking Dead Action Figures and Memorabilia, and the link will be in the description below as well. And if you're a fan of any of these Walking Dead action figures, I highly recommend you join our group. We are the first to announce any kind of news, McFarlane related, Minimates related, anything Walking Dead action figure or memorabilia related. We are the first to announce it on Facebook. So please come over and join our page. And we also are a buy and sell group as well. So come over and check us out. And thanks everybody for checking out my review of Jesus. And hopefully we'll be getting a Black Friday Skybound exclusive too. I don't know. This may kind of count as it for this year, but wouldn't that be something else if we got another one here in a couple weeks? That'd be great. But all right, guys. Again, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more. The Walking Dead TV Series 6 action figures should be coming out within the next month. And we got the Walking Dead building sets that are kind of like Legos coming out next week. And I will be getting those and reviewing them. So stay tuned for all that stuff, guys. Later.